HBCU hosted gymnastics event on the collegiate level. Brother Greer, you are a fist lover. Tell us what this means to you as it relates to historical.
I have a granddaughter who got into gymnastics. This allows her to see folks who look like her doing it. And that's fine. That's how we learn, by seeing folks who look like us doing things we're not doing.
It's absolutely true. Biscuits has this year the highest enrollment had since 1979. This may enhance that enrollment next year.
Well, most of the time, what has happened is our kids are they're starting to realize that they need to learn about us so they can really go and deal with them. What does that mean? There's a book written by Gloria Thomas Miller titled Who We Are. And it's the story of the last of the segregated graduates of schools in Nashville. And it's the hardest that 12 years, almost 5 years, we had folks who looked like us telling us what we need to do and what we didn't need to do, correcting us if we were wrong, so that we could be prepared to go and create the technology to create the cell phone that could get us on task. And that's what these kids are starting to look for. They've been in school with white folks all their lives. All their lives. They have been always the other kids in the classroom. And going to the business, going to Howard, going to the Tuskegee, gives them an opportunity to grow up in the village. Where everybody in the village looks like them.
Thank you, my brother.
My name is Chelsea Aggie, and I'm from Lawton, Oklahoma.
Lawton, Oklahoma. That's where Langston is, isn't it?
Correct.
You went to school in Langston?
I didn't. I attended Prairie View A&M University.
How did you feel about being at the first gymnastics competition sponsored by HBCU?
It's an honor and it's amazing. I'm excited because my daughter is actually a gymnast and a cheerleader in Nashville, so I'm doing it for her. I'm really excited.
Is she competing or is she
no,
still not?
She's still in the middle school.
Well, we want her when she gets here.
Thank you. I'm so happy to be here.
Well, I guess, like me, you're not seeing a gymnast.
Not on the collegiate level, but at a competition.
Yeah,
it's starting
actually.
Okay,
fine.
You ready?
How are
you? My name is Cecil Beard, and I'm the class of 76, Fisher University, former football player, wide receiver. And this is?
I am Jackie
Buck Beard
from Detroit, Michigan, former cheerleader.
Tell us what you think of being at the first ever gymnastics event hosted by an HBCU.
I think it's great, and I'm gonna tell you something. We're gonna take over this HBCU. We're gonna take over.
This is the first time that a dominantly black institution is competing. Watch out.
We're so proud of the university and the talent and athletes that they have out here. It just warms my heart that we're making history, and we're just glad to be a part of it. We're glad to be here.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, you're so crazy.
I'm
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the Pete Lads for your state
thank you. placing first from Fisk with a spread of 9.87, Morgan Price. Placing third on bars, from Fisk with a score of 9.52, Zena Brewer. Placing second from Fisk with a score of 9.77, Kiara Richmond. Placing first from Fisk with a score of 9.95, Morgan Price. On beam, placing third for Fisk University with a score of 9.67, Aaliyah Reed Hammond. Placing second with a score of 9.77, Liberty Mora. Placing first from Greenville with a score of 9.80, Amara Nelson. On floor. For Fisk University with a score of 9.57, Kiara Richmond. Placing second from Greenville with a score of 9.67, Amara Nelson. In first place from Fisk University with a score of 9.87, Morgan Price.
You go, Morgan.
Here are your scores for the all-around event. Placing third from Greenville with a score of 36.15, Molly Proven. Placing second from Greenville with a score of 38.32, Amara Nelson. And placing first from Fisk University with a score of 39.17, Morgan Price. The final scores for the meet is Greenville 183.87, Fisk University 190.
When you graduated, they were talking about that. Joe Herbert, class of 1971, Fisk University.
Joe, tell us about the significance of this Jim Haskins, first ever hosted by
HBCU. I enjoyed it. It was worthwhile, and I think everybody else who was in attendance here enjoyed what was taking place this evening. We were very excited to have Tony Holman aren't in our
I'm Karen Williams Bunch, graduate of 75 class at Fisk University. So happy to be here. Go Fisk!
Sydney Bunch, class of 75. Glad to be here. Tell us what you think the significance of this first ever gymnastics meet run by HBCU.
So proud. We were the first. Hope there'll be many more. And we've given them a good group to follow because we are awesome.
I think we've given them a great showing. And I think there's more to come.
Okay, thank you.
I'm Howard Gentry. I went to Tennessee State University. I graduated in 1974, but I have been on Fisk campus ever since I was born.
Howard, the significance of a first ever domestic meet held by HBCU is almost indescribable.
You know what?
You think.
I was just telling a Fisk graduate that I never thought that I would get to see this type of history in my lifetime at any HBCU. And the fact that it's this is so cool. I just wish my parents were here to be able to see it and a lot of the trailblazers, because this is why we have HBCUs, because we can do anything. And tonight was an example of it.
Amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm Patricia Turner, class of 1966, the centennial class from this university, Nashville, Tennessee.
What do you think the significance of the first ever gymnastic meet?